There's no percentage marker, so I honestly don't know, but we're 19 hours into the game. Now, mind you, as I said, all right. Now, as you can see, I got the viewpoints, like I said. I feel like it'd just be best to cut them out for now. I also bought some treasure maps. We're just gonna... There we go. We have no... We actually don't really have need for them. So here we go. We're going for the codex page. So you may want to hire these courtesans. They're on the other side here. There they are. There we go. Just gonna sit here while we're waiting for the courtesans to do their job. Now, I did find out that I don't have access to this region yet, so we're going to leave that codex page for now, and we're just going to pursue this assassin's tomb before we get on the next mission. Now, one of the reasons why I think there was a big mess up with my Assassin's Creed Let's Play was due to the fact that I was trying to do it all on my Xbox. We have a glyph here. Okay, so it's specifically this building. There's no other building in this shop. So... Ooh, that's clever. I was only going up there to get tying a good view, but... Okay, it's a picture one. Now, mind you, this one's also accompanied by... That's the ground. The death of all tyrants will say. No idea who that was supposed to be. John Wilkes Boot. Francio de Vos. Francesco, Pizarro, Cleopatra, Thomas, not it is. Mary the First of England, Rasputin, Joseph Stalin. We're down to five.
merchant Medardo of San Polo has been found guilty of treason against the Serene Republic and will be executed publicly.
There's another one. This time, oh, that's a lot of ground to cover. Shit. Lazio.
Vile murderer! Stay away!
Please, be civilized!
Out of my...
There we go. Nope. It's a feather.
You have, aha! Stop him! Order!
And there's one of my final lines.
What do you think you're...
Guy got bounced off the roof. Could be hidden on one of these bits here.
Another corpse. Still warm.
Dannato!
Eyes open!
What is
Anyone
the meaning of
the fight?
Oh no,
I should get help.
Now, clear off.
Alert! There he is! Laju! Passo! You think you can outrun, huh?
Approach and smile upon you all.
Faster! We're losing him!
Ugh!
won't escape!
This won't take long.
Oh, it's a varying. I should just aim for the assassin's tomb. Thank you. need to get to that organ. Oh my God, can I not? So up there, all along there, then go along those pillars. Right. It lost me during this, at some point during the start. Then from up here, sprint, get some extra momentum for here, climb up, high, then vault, climb back up here, and then, no, you sons of fucking bitch, biggest downfall of the Assassin's Creed franchise is like that. Now, again, it gets better in later Assassin's Creed games, but like, dear God. Like, I don't remember never doing that in, like, Unity, or Odyssey, or even Origins. But again, this is the second game in the franchise, so... therefore you have to I have to give it some leeway. It's just that you forget about it. There we go. Swing, jump to there, then we run along that pillar, get to there, then jump along those beams, climb up to that, then use the crosses to get onto their side, then run over, then climb up the outside of the thing, and then jump onto that. Wow, okay. this, and then we have to go along this, then to here. On this last one. So run over to there, get up onto those things. No idea how I'm supposed to get up onto those things. There we go. That was a really frustrating one. So I think that was that not the last one? Shit, no, was it? Nope, we're missing one more seal. It just popped up there. And I have messages. Well, the next one's probably somewhere along there. So let's get to the story, because for the life of me, I cannot figure out where the truth symbol is there. Database. Oh, wonder there. It's locations. We have 5 out of 5 there. 6 out of 6 tower 2. So it literally the last ones we need are in Venice. This is the one that has me fucking stumped. One of those strange glyphs Sean mentioned is on this landmark. Originally built as a watchtower named Central Queen, which was transformed into a bell tower. Each one of 5 bells has a special purpose. What? Okay, so it's the bell tower. Okay, so maybe I should actually read these things to find out exactly what I'm looking for. And then this is. So it's on the bell tower somewhere.
What a peculiar man.
Okay, I can hear it. Oh, another clever one.
It happened in 1908. Or was it 2008, 1708. I can't remember.
Now, see, the worst part about this is we go to locations. I need to refine that building then. Wait, Speedy Theolis Church, that's near where we arrived. So it's around here. across the river. Pretty sure it was before we crossed over. I believe we came so we came down here. There we go. Wait. Oh, this is it. This is the building. Okay, looking for the number. Numbers. Looking for the symbology. Wait. Okay, I see the. What's it called? The sort of arrowhead thing pointing to the left in the picture of the tank. So all I need now is a number. Not seeing any numbers in the any of the pictures. The only image that's coming up is that four that's not part of any of the pictures. And I'm pretty sure it's not, that's not it, but yep. First, for the sake of it, let's assign that to the four. So one's hidden, nine is that, and one is, so seven and one are hidden. Okay, well that's nine. Then that's 0, so that should be 1. And then 7. I can't figure out the pattern here. We need to find the W. Okay, there it is. All right, let's look for any other numbers. I'm not seeing anything in the images of the fire, the three soldiers. I'm not seeing anything what looks to be the picture. over mountainside. Two soldiers running. No Claremont there. Then we have 2 inches of D-Day. And I'm not seeing a number, any numbers floating in the background. See, the clues don't generally fade out. That's the thing. Like, that's what I'm trying to ignore that for. It's because, like, that symbol, you can see it in the picture of the tank just above the door, and the man in the Jeep. It's set there. Like, it doesn't vanish. So that means I know that is one of the clues. Now the next clue is gonna have a similar situation. And it's going to be in one of the pictures, but I just, for the life of me, cannot see it.
Right, this one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
Wait, what's
right,
that?
This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
The shape, something that we can
right.
Count.
This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
Be the points. What's common? What is common about all these?
Right. This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
Something on them that we can count.
Right. This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
So I would like to say it's points, but no. Like, look, there's the circle, and then there's... Like, there's the infinity symbol right there. Then these have curves as well, and then that has a line. I'm not seeing the pattern. And again, this symbol right here, that shows up in the picture with the tank. If I can get the corresponding goddamn number part of it, then we're sorted. And that is what's eluding me right now. There has to be a number hidden somewhere in the pictures. Some kind of clue. See, I would like to say that the soldiers in one of the pictures is the number, but like there's a two and this and a three, and then there's like the two images of D-Day, which are just so many people you can't really count them. And the same goes for the image of the army looking at the mountain.
Right, this one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
There's absolutely nothing in the image of the soldiers, the two soldiers that are looking like they're running or charging. There's no image of the burning building that I can immediately see. I'm not seeing anything in D-Day. Where we are from the perspective of one of the boats opening up. And then the other image of people coming off the boats and wading through the water. I'm not seeing anything there. Nothing in the clouds. Nothing in the water.
Right. This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
We have six pictures. Is it a number of pictures? Like, is that it? And see, that's the thing, like, okay, see, by this thing, the seven is that weird N-like thing. So by, see, like that, but that's next, and then that's next. I'm not saying any rhyme or reason. Let's see. It's two. It jumps two to get to that. And then let's see. When does it get to the? So it jumps that to get to that, and then it goes into a normal pattern. Then. No
right, like this one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
I think I have it. Okay, so seven is this. Nine is this. And then one is this because it has 1 point. So that's not it. Could be lines. But the... One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. This is so confusing. See, it's all these additional circle ones that's also throwing me off, like, you know? What the hell is it?
Right, this one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
Could that be two because of World War II?
This one is tricky. There must be something distinctive about those shapes. Something on them that we can count.
Alright. The only thing I can think of doing now is doing this. Which is where I basically keep aligning the thing that I see in the tank picture with other locations until I get some kind of code. So back to my original theory where this is 9, 1 and 7 are unknown, which does not help at all because again I don't know what I'm looking for. There must be something I am just missing. Something that is staring me right in the face. Because again, in the tank picture, above the Jeep or truck or whatever, on the side of the building, above the man in the door, there is that symbol with the two lines. So that symbol is obviously part of our clue to figure it out. So somewhere in these pictures is a number. And it's just somewhere there. Must be one of the symbols. Like, I'm dead certain the four and the goddamn less than symbol is the figured out. That was it.
They engineered the war, they engineered the peace, but they weren't going to get away with it. Find our mark.
Can't read that. We watched the exit from above and they didn't see us coming, so yeah. I wasted so much time on that one, and I'm so sorry, guys. But that was a real proper goddamn puzzle. Like, dear God. Let's get a bit done with the story. We can give some things to Leonardo.
Hey, where do you think you are?
Careful with that law. Leonardo.
Ezio, so good to see you. How can I help you?
Ha ha! You found another one! How exciting!
I just have to substitute this letter and move this over there. I've got it.
Please come again. Bring me your sick and wounded.
Where is Emilio?
I told him to be here.
You told him yourself? In person?
Yes, myself, in person. I'm concerned that you don't trust me.
As am I. Perhaps you'll arrive with the others. Walk with me. How go things in the palace?
Honestly, it's difficult. Mocenigo keeps his circle closed. I've tried to lay the groundwork, making suggestions, but he has other voices at his ears.
Then you must work hard. You must become part of his inner circle.
See, I understand. But it's harder than I expected.
And why is that, Carlo?
I don't know. He just... the Doge doesn't like me.
I wonder why.
It's not my fault. I keep trying to please him. I learn what he craves and I have it delivered. The finest jams from the orchards of Sardinia. The newest fashions from Milano.
Yes, and that's called being a sycophant.
A what? What did you call me?
A doormat. A flatterer. A bootlicker. Need I go on?
Bastardo. You don't know what it's like. You don't understand the pressure in there.
Oh, I don't understand pressure.
No, you have no idea. You are a government official. From the Doge himself. I am beside him day and night. You wish you could be where I am.
I'm done.
Hardly. You listen to me now. The Doge can be recruited to our cause, I'm sure of it. Just, I need a little more time.
Time is not a thing we have in great supply.
But I don't even think. Feast my eyes upon that, so looking for a good time.
Keep moving.
Is it much further?
Don't be such a little girl.
Buongiorno, cousin. Signor Carlo?
We thought Emilio would be with you.
Emilio is dead.
What? How?
The assassin. The same one who hunted down the Pazzi. He's here in Venezia.
E così? Silvio, did you not know? He could be anywhere. He could be here right now, and we might not even know. He struck Emilio inside his own palazzo.
And so, what of our plans?
There is no longer time for subtlety, my brothers. We must act now.
But Marco, I am so close. A few more days, if I can just...
No. It happens this week. We should keep moving.
What does the Spaniard have to say of this change of plan?
All right.
You can ask him yourself soon enough.
He's here? From Roma?
So I've heard.
Good. Perhaps he's made a decision.
About what, cousin?
About which of us shall step into the robes of the dog.
I didn't know there was a decision to be made. Surely the choice is obvious to all.
Obvious indeed. It should be the one who organized the entire operation, the one who came up with the idea of how to save the city.
There is no lack of value in tactical intelligence, good Silvio. But it is wisdom one needs to rule. Do not think otherwise.
Calma, calma, amici. Please. There's no need for fear. You know it's not up to you. All we know, you may not even choose, but... And why not me? I'm the one who's done all the hard work.
Basta! We wait for his arrival.
Are you sure he's coming?
Yes!
Signori, we should move a little faster. I feel eyes on us.
Thank you, Dante. We will move at your pace.
This guard's a good find. How much did you pay for him?
Perhaps not as much as he deserves. He saved my life on two occasions. Though he's not much of a conversationalist.
Enough with your inane prattle. The choice of Doge was never up to any of you, and you were never given permission to make plans.
Forgive us, Maestro. We wish only to serve.
The plan is this. Doge Mocenigo will die tonight. And once the deed's been done, Marco shall take his place.
Vi ringrazio umilmente, maestro.
Good. Messer Grimaldi, you are closest to Mocenigo. You work the most vital. Serve us well, and it won't be forgotten. Walk with me. I don't want any blood spilled, you understand? Must appear to all that he goes quietly.
Certo, maestro.
When are you closest to him?
I have full run of the palace. He may not care to hear what I have to say, but he trusts me by now as one of his own.
Bravo. Then I want you to infiltrate the kitchen and poison his meal.
So be it.
Marco, can you furnish us with a suitable toxin on short notice?
I defer to my cousin. That is really his area of expertise.
Ah, Silvio.
I am at your service, Maestro.
What can you bring to get this done?
I will confer with my associates in the streets, but chances are good that I can procure some Candarella.
Yes, and what is that?
It is a most effective form of arsenic and difficult. Trace.
Ah, va bene, va bene. Then it's decided.
All right, then.
What's a girl to do surrounded by so many handsome gentlemen?
Have you ever seen more beautiful maids?
You need to relax, Monsieur.
Let me show you. Two men dance.
Yeah.
A kiss for a virgin, too. Un sano. What's that?
forgive me, Maestro, but is this not perhaps a tad dangerous for you, involving yourself so intimately with the minutiae of our plans?
I feel the need to involve myself more directly. The Bazzi disappointed us in Firenze. I pray you will not do the same.
Do not worry this time. The Bazzi were a bunch of foolish...
The Bazzi were a potent and venerable family, reduced to rubble by one young assassin. Do not underestimate this troublesome foe who now haunts your city. Or the same fate will befall the Barbarico. I want this done promptly. Bene, I must return to Roma. Time is of the essence. Do not fail us.
Che idiota sono. I should have kept my eyes on them. I need to go and see Antonio if I have any hope of salvaging this mess I've made.
Wait a second.
It's getting harder. All the pain across time. It hurts too much. She sees me raise the knife. Little bit longer now. In the beginning, Genesis.
Okay, we'd see a five clearly. So we're looking for some other symbols, and I see one of the symbols. There we go. So six. Zero and three are unknown. So, five is possibly that. So, what's so special about it? What is the five? Let's go through the symbols. Right, well, let's look at the two symbols that are missing. Is that there? Yes, it is. Those two of those, yes, that's there. One and like a stack is missing, so that's. It had something to do with the maths equation. So 5 plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1 plus 5 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4. The absolute fuck. See, that does not show up anywhere. So it must be one of those. They don't show up there. So we'll try these. There must be some sort of indication. What does the 6 have in common with those? And what does the 5 have in common with the that symbol?
Alright, this is a hard one. It's fine. Those numbers on the screen, they've got to be there for a reason. I don't know if this helps, but I know the symbols on the wheel. They're Sumerian numerals. Those tree shapes, they're ones. And the sideways Vs are tens. Maybe the numbers and the Sumerian numerals connect somehow.
Wait, what?
Alright, this is a hard one. It's fine. Those numbers on the screen, they've got to be there for a reason. I don't know if this helps, but I know the symbols on the wheel. They're Sumerian numerals. Those tree shapes, they're ones. And the sideways Vs are tens. Maybe the numbers and the Sumerian numerals connect somehow. Alright, this is a hard one. It's fine. Those numbers on the screen, they've got to be there for a reason. I don't know if this helps, but I know the symbols on the wheel. They're Sumerian numerals. Those tree shapes, they're ones, and the sideways Vs are tens. Maybe the numbers and the Sumerian numerals connect somehow.
Okay, so those three symbols are tens. No, sorry, the sideways Vs are the tens.
Alright, this is a hard one. It's fine. Those numbers on the screen, they've got to be there for a reason. I don't know if this helps, but I know the symbols on the wheel. They're Sumerian numerals. Those tree shapes, they're ones. And the sideways Vs are tens. Maybe the numbers and the Sumerian numerals connect somehow.
Okay. So that means we have 1 plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1 plus 5 plus 3, plus 5, plus 6, plus 4. That gets us a total of 35, unless I'm mistaken. So, That can't be right. Like, that means under in 6 we have 3. Then in 0 we have 37. And then 31. Well, let me try that. Maybe, let's try to get 1 plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1 plus 5 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4. Okay, yeah, so that gets us to 35. Now, assuming that potentially that one at the start is supposed to be a 5, then that gets us up an additional 4. That gets us to 39. But that still doesn't make sense. Oh.
The organization wanted the pieces. They tasted their power. But what were the pieces? Why did they work so well? It's as if our minds were made for them, manufactured to obey.
We're 2 away.
Salute, bello mio. Come stai? You back to see me already?
Desolato, mia cara. But I am not here to play. I must speak with Antonio. It's urgent.
Antonio! Ezio's here!
Ezio, is everything all right?
Carlo Grimaldi and the Barbarigo are in league with the one they call the Spaniard. They're going to murder the Doge and replace him with one of their own. They will have all of Venezia, their entire fleet, in their grasp.
And they call me a criminal.
Then you'll help me.
You have me on your side, brother. And the support of all my men.
And women.
Grazie, amici.
But, Ezio, I must warn you. It's not going to be so easy this time. Palazzo Ducale is the most heavily guarded building in Venezia.
Nothing is impenetrable.
This is why we like you, Ezio.
Come, Let's go take a look. We'll come up with a plan. Nice business with the Doge. Terrible. Though, treachery like this no longer surprises me. When I was a child, we were taught that the nobles were just and kind. I believed it. Though my father was only a cobbler, and my mother a scullery maid, I aspired to be much more. I studied hard. I persevered. But the nobles would never have me. If you are not born one of them, acceptance is impossible. So I ask you, Ezio, who are the true nobles of Venezia? Men like Carlo Grimaldi and Marco Barbarigo. No! I say we are the thieves and mercenary and whores. While we work to save this city and its people, the nobles seek to make it their plaything. We need to scout the palazzo carefully. See it from every angle. We just might find a way in. I know of a tall campanile behind the palazzo. Or we might find a way to climb the back of the basilica. Do you have any ideas?
I assume the front door is out.
Va bene. We'll try the front door as well, Saputello.
So, what do you think?
We're not getting in this way. They'll have time to murder the Doge before we're able to get through all these guards. Look at that. Archers everywhere.
And the walls are impossible to climb on this side.
Bene. We're in luck. Looks like there's a perfect path up the scaffolding, to the roof of the basilica. Shall we?
Ezio, look! Isn't that him? Grimaldi!
Don't you understand what I'm offering you, Signore? Listen to me, please. Or this will be your last chance.
How dare you!
I'm sorry. Mi dispiace. I meant nothing by it. I'm only looking out for your safety.
We're running out of time. There's no way through this fence, and there are guards everywhere. Diavolo!
On me.
It's impossible. There's no way in or out for men. Only birds.
Yes. Birds.
Where are you going now?
To see my friend Leonardo.
And we're getting to one of the funniest missions in the game.
I need your help, Leonardo. Does it work?
What? What are you asking?
Does it work, Leonardo? Can it really fly?
I don't know. It's only a prototype. An idea. It's not ready yet.
Have you tried it?
No. It's too dangerous. To test it, you'd have to leap off a tower. Who would be mad enough to do a thing like that?
Leonardo, I think you just found your madman. So, how does she work?
Have you ever watched a bird in flight? It's not about being lighter than air. It's about grace and balance. You must use your body's own weight to control your elevation and direction.
Good luck, Ezio.
Crashing! This is ridiculous! The palazzo's too far away! Diavolo! I give up! I'm gonna end up killing myself before I ever kill another Templar!
You flew!
See, but not very far.
Well, what were you expecting? The machine wasn't designed for distance. All right, look. Let me go over my plans here. Maybe I can find some way to extend the duration of the flight.
Ezio, my men tell me Carlo has the poison. We must hurry.
Antonio, this is Leonardo, the master inventor who built this pezzo di merda.
Hey, it's not the machine's fault. It's mine. I've checked and rechecked my blueprints. It's just impossible. Don't know how to extend the flight. Da, che idea del cazzo! Eureka! Of course! Genio!
What is he doing now?
It rises. It needs fire. Heated air under its wings will lift the machine.
Leonardo, what good is one fire going to do?
Not one fire, Ezio. A dozen, built all across the city. Enough to carry you from here all the way to the Palazzo Ducale.
How? Ah, capisco. My men could do that, but you are forgetting about the guards.
Don't worry. I will take care of them.
I'll give the order to have my men move in behind you and hold the locations. They'll light them all up the second the sun goes down over San Marco.
Shipment from China. Some kind of colored powder they brought over for a big party. Really expensive. You ask me. The way these girls are.
Enough of you left to bury!
Maestro Prioli, the great artist.
Lead on.
Hold it right there!
Let them have it.
Today? I don't know. Something about your cowering, abject terror brings back memories.
Enough! Enough! We've got work to do. Pick more and more of these imbecili on the streets.
Get down! Back to the
days.
nation meet their match in his defiance.
That's a man. Not like an eagle.
It's time.
You did it. It's beautiful.
See. Now let's hope your idea works, because we're nearly out of time.
Listen close, Ezio. You're going to want to fly from fire to fire. The heat of each one you pass over should lift you back up in the air again.
Bene. Careful, though. There's archers out on the roofs tonight. Avoid those arrows, or it will be a short trip.
I wish there was some way I could use my sword while flying this thing. Well, you do have your feet free. If you get close enough without taking an arrow in the head, maybe you could kick them off the building.
Nice. It's now or never, amico mio.
Ah, one of the best machines in the game.
Ma cos'è? Shoot! Shoot the flying demon!
Trying to kick one off. I'm just gonna focus on the evasive maneuvers.
was that?
Don't worry. Probably just kids with firecrackers. Come, it's your move.
Wait, what?
Stop! Signore, don't drink that!
You are too late. The Doge is dead.
What? Carlo?
Apologies, Signore. But you should have listened to me when you had the chance. Seems you have failed, assassin.
Forgive me, Signore. I tried.
Why? What was it all for?
Assassino! Assassino! He's killed the Doge! The Doge is dead!
I see him! Dead!
Filio di puttana!
It takes one assassin to kill another, it seems.
We kill thinking it's best for us. Do we not, Messer Ezio?
I do this not for myself.
Compio questo sacrificio per il bene superiore. Requiescat in pace.
You killed me? You killed me?
Ezio! Dio mio! You're alive! Is it true? They say you killed the Doge.
I was trying to save him, Leonardo. But the truth matters little. I failed. And now I'm the most wanted man in Venezia.
Well, perhaps you are in luck. It's Carnevale in Venezia. This is the time when everybody goes without a face.
That's why I'm here. Do you have a mask I can wear?
Of course, of course. Somewhere in here.
Grazie, amico mio. I have something for you.
Oh, more of the Codex. Aha. This one's quite complex. It's a new design, my friend.
A mechanism for your wrist, but not a blade. In fact, it seems to be a kind of arma da fuoco, but as small as a hummingbird. Is that possible? I have no idea. Let's build it and find out.
You've done me good, brother.
Ma certo. But I'm sure your return was not just to play with new toys. Is it about this terrible new doge they've installed? Marco Barbarigo. Then you'll want to speak with your friend Antonio. I've seen him quite a bit lately at... mutual friends. I'd look for him there, in the Dorsoduro district, to the south. Ask for Sister Teodora.
Sister?
Well, in a way. Yes. Sister, and Ezio, you can't be carrying weapons out there today.
Grazie, Leonardo. Now, about that mask.
Marco Barbarigo. Although his brother Agostino was destined for greatness, Marco left his mark on Venetian history as well. A tyrant since he was barely old enough to walk, whatever Marco wanted, he got. There are records here for jewels, entire fleets of ships, all paid for by his family and all ordered directly from him. And then there's his personal life. Apparently, Marco's wife, Carlotta, used to be married to his bodyguard, Dante Moro. Dante was captain of the city guard, an heir to one of the most prestigious families in Venezia. Marco was supposedly his close friend, right? But get this. Marco decides he wants Carlotta. In the Catholic religion, marriage is till death do us part, and Marco's a good Catholic. So, he hires a hit on Dante. Dante gets stabbed 3 times in the body, and once in the head. But he doesn't die. He recovers with severe brain damage. Dante becomes like a child. So, what does Marco do? Well, he hires Dante as his personal bodyguard, and he gets him to sign a confession annulling the marriage. Marco takes Carlotta, and keeps Dante as his personal slave. What a lovely fella.
Judging by the location of that, we must be able to access this and the last Sassignon tomb. And with that, we're going to take a break, folks. I am hungry, and we've been at it for, well, about 5 hours or so today. So I'll be taking another about 3 minute break, and then we'll be back. Who knows, we might even get Assassin's Creed to done tonight. But for now, I need a quick game. Otherwise, the audio is going to mess up again when I get back to doing the stream. This is Rival Ninja, signing out.